Hello, good evening, everyone. My name is Giovanna Fulvi, and I'm one of the international programmers with the Toronto International Film Festival. Welcome to the North American premiere screening of Saturday Fiction, directed by Lo Ye. To begin, we would like to acknowledge that tonight's event is taking place on the treaty territory of the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation and the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee, Anishinaabe, and the Huron-Wendat. We're grateful to have the opportunity to work in the community. This film is eligible for the Grosch Choice Award, so if you like this film, please do not forget to vote at the end of the screening, and you can do so at tiff.net/vote. We would like to thank Creative Artist Agency, CAA, and Wild Bunch for providing us with this film. Lo Ye is one of the most respected and renowned auteurs from China, who is admired for his bold approaches to filmmaking. He's a regular at TIFF, and he has been here with many of his previous films, including Summer Palace, Spring Fever, Purple Butterfly, and many others. Saturday Fiction is his latest feature. It's a film that takes us back to wartime Shanghai for a sweeping tale of intrigue. Saturday Fiction is a fascinating movie which does not have a linear narrative structure, but perfectly captures the atmosphere of Shanghai in 1941. And now, without further ado, please join me in welcoming on stage the director of the film, Lo Ye.
Good
evening, everyone. Thank you very much for coming to see the movie. Very glad to meet you here.
让我介绍我们的团队的成员。首先介绍编剧和制片人英丽，马英丽。
So let me introduce our crew. And the first person I would like to bring up is our writer and our producer, Miss Ma Yingli.
然后介绍一下我们的男主演赵又廷。
And then our leading man, Mr. Mark Zhao.
。Thank you everyone for coming to see our movie. We put a lot of heart and soul and effort into it.And had a lot of fun making it, and really hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you.
还有我们的女主演巩俐。
And then our leading lady, Miss Gong Li.
大家好，我是中国演员巩俐，特别。
Hello everyone, I am the Chinese actress. My name is Gong Li.
非常高兴今天来到多伦多跟大家一起，希望大家能喜欢我们的电影，我也希望能够再跟大家一起看一遍我们这部片子。谢谢大家。
Very happy to be here in Toronto and to meet everyone here. I really hope everyone like and enjoy the film, and I'm also very glad that I will be here to enjoy the film with you all. Thank you.
director and cast will be back at the end of the screening for the question and answer session. Thank you and enjoy. So just to start the conversation, I'd like to ask a question that is actually both for the director Lo Ye and also for Mai Yin Li. How did you conceive the idea to make this film? How did you work on this project? And how the two of you collaborated on writing and making this film?
其实是一个比较偶然的一个机会，我们是想就是说做一个觉得空间啊或者是场景都不是太复杂的一个影片，然后各种机缘吧，然后碰到红衣女士的这个小说，然后觉得是跟这个剧院和酒店这两个空间有关系，就觉得好像应该是拍起来一个比较集中比较小的一个片子，没想到后来就变得其实也不那么简单也不那么小。
Well, it's actually started by chance. We actually wanted to make a movie that has something that talk about space and perhaps a small and simple space. And then we met Hong Ying and the talk about the project start to develop. And then there's the idea of perhaps the scene, the space would be a theater, a hotel, and that's how it gets evolved. And then turned out it's not so simple of a space.
主要责任在我，对。
And I suppose I'm the one responsible for that.
And can you also talk about, Lo Ye, the stylistic choices for the film? Why black and white and also like the handheld camera? That is almost like stalking all the characters into action that I find really powerful and beautiful.
Would you like to speak up a little bit?
I'm sorry. I'm asking about the stylistic choices that he made, the use of the black and white. And also the handheld camera.
Well, I think black and white is the color of that era, and the image and the information that we get relate to that era is often in black and white. And I do think black and white, after all, are colors.
And then also now question for Mark Chao. How did you, can you share your experience in working in this movie and starting with how you were casted for the role?
For consistency, I will speak in Mandarin and please translate for me. Because we're a team, right? So, 很荣幸能够参与到这么优秀的作品，跟这么优秀的伙伴们一起合作。非常巧的是，一开始其实我跟导演是因为另外一个项目，其实我是带着另外一个项目去见导演，然后请他指导。但结果那个会的最后是他说，我这儿有另外一个东西，你要不要来看一看？然后就这么就开始了，对。
It's an honor to be working on this project. It's a wonderful project with wonderful people to collaborate with. And in terms of how I got started, actually, I went to the director. We were supposed to do another project. And somehow, once we were talking and meeting about the other project, he said, well, there's actually another project. So that's how this got started.
And now a question for Gong Li. Your performance is amazing. You are charismatic. It's a performance that is powerful, intense, graceful. It's just amazing. And your character carries the film throughout. And I just wanted to ask you, how did you prepare for it?
谢谢你，首先。
Thank you first.
这个角色其实真的是，首先感谢导演能选择我来演这个角色，好像是一个有点百年不遇的一个角色吧，对我来说。
Well, first of all, I should thank the director for choosing me to play this role. I would think this is kind of role that comes once in 100 years.
自己一直很喜欢挑战自己没有拍过的角色。
I always love challenges. I like to play roles that I have not played before.
这个角色对我来说，它的意义所在就是，在那个时期，在一个中国的一个灾难的一个时期，在二战时期，中国的灾难和我们所有的人民都受到了这个灾难的冲击。那我在这里面表演这个人物，我觉得在中国那个时候，应该有很多非常非常多的像于锦这样的女性来站出来去反击战争。
And this film is set in a terrible era of the time when China is suffering from the war and people are experiencing tremendous sufferings. And that's in that terrible time, I felt there must be a lot of people, a lot of women who had to stand up and have to step forward and do the things that she did.
在准备这个角色的时候看了非常多的资料，跟导演每天都在谈剧本。导演特别感谢导演非常愿意就是听我们所有演员的意见。
I read a lot regarding the material, the background material, and we also had a lot of discussions of the script. I really grateful that the director is so appreciative of our inputs.
因为在这个电影里面要学很多的有技巧性的一些技巧，比如说是催眠，在催眠上面我们学了差不多一个月，跟的一个非常专业的一个老师学催眠术，学开枪，因为我当时拿那个枪，导演也帮我选了一个男士的那个手枪，那个枪很重，所以在开枪的过程中你那个手一定要是很强壮，所以练枪法，练习这个催眠术，这些都是一些在电影里要展现的。这个准备工作差不多有两个月的时间。
There were in terms of preparation, there were a lot of actual techniques that's involved in the film that I need to learn. For example, I had to learn how to do the hypnosis. And that actually took me a month. We actually had to learn from a therapist. And so that is something I actually had to learn to do to prepare for the film. And also shooting a gun, and the director chose a man's gun. It's very big and very heavy. And I have to actually learn how to shoot in the particular type of gun. So all that, there were a lot of learning of the actual techniques that I had to do that took about maybe 2 months.
现在我这个催眠术学得非常好。等一会儿我再说一会儿的话可能你们都睡着了。
So I'm very, very good at hypnosis now. So let me talk for a little longer. Maybe you guys will all fall asleep.
谢谢大家，谢谢。
Thank you.
And now questions from the audience. Yes, please. You on the white. Can you repeat the question? We didn't.
Sorry.
We didn't.
So accept the music using the play in the movie, that's a good fiction, and how do you decide on like using such good music?
So the question is about the music. There is little music in the film, only the music in the play. How did you decide, why did you decide to have that little music?
实际上就是这部片子实际上没有另外的作曲，就是我们选择了一个舞台的配乐，然后实际上只是唯一的音乐。
So we do not have a composer for the film per se. We have the music for the stage show, and that's the part that has music.
我希望整个影片都是没有任何的干扰人物和故事的进展。
So the effect that I would like to achieve is that so it will not be any distraction for the character and for the story.
Other questions? Yes, please.
我觉得导演用这一句这个诗词这句话的意图也是要表现跟跟这个电影吧是吻合的啊，跟这个女演员的心态也是吻合的，因为她跟她父亲说的最后一句话就是说我这是最后的一次任务吧，这个我觉得这是她看得很准。
Well, I think that quote is something that fits in with the movie, and that's why it is in the movie. And I think also the character, when she said at the end that this is going to be my last role, I think that's also something that go with that.
Thank you.
Other questions? Yes, please.
So maybe I'll translate that question first. So the question is directed to Mark. And so the question is that in China, a lot of people refer to Ms. Gong as Empress Gong. So to play opposite Empress Gong, what that feels like, is there pressure?
我先帮他回答，因为我在拍戏的时候呢，还没等拍的时候我就开始给他催眠，完了以后把他催眠的差不多的时候呢，他根本都不认识我了，所以他没有什么紧张的。
So because Miss Gong had already learned hypnosis, so she was hypnotizing him during the whole thing. So he, at the end, he barely could recognize her.
I'm still hypnotized to this day. I have not recovered from. 开玩笑了，但就是其实我们相处的过程然后熟识的过程非常顺利跟融洽，并没有所谓的巨大的压力，因为这一点是我就是特别佩服跟特别欣赏巩皇的一点，是因为上来他就说你演的是导演，所以都交给你吧，所以我觉得这由他来对我说这句话代表的那种信任，我觉得是怎么讲，是令我敬佩的，所以我当下就决定说呢，千万不能有任何压力，必须要好好的演这一段戏。
Well, it's a very smooth, very harmonized cooperation, that's for sure. And what I really find very moving and impressed by was at the very beginning of our collaboration, she said to me, she said, well, you're the one who's playing a director. So it's up to you. And so for her, at her position, to say that to me at the beginning of our collaboration, I'm very, very appreciative and respectful of what she did. So as a result, it was no pressure playing with Empress Go.
We have time for just one last question. The gentleman here on the white shirt.
Yeah.
You.
Hi, thank you for a great movie.
Yeah. Well, we should talk about the movie. We should, concentrate on the movie. Unfortunately,
对，我同意啊，就是应该是谈电影的。但是我可以说一下这个电影，就是说，在结尾部分，你发现暴力进入这个剧场，这个片子里面你会看到，一旦暴力进入剧场，演戏的和看戏的。
So I do like to make a comment, which is what being portrayed in the movie as well is that if you see violence that comes into the theater, then it doesn't matter whether you're on stage or your audience, no one can escape from that violence that protrude into the theater.
Thank you. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight. Thank you all. Thank you.